gut, you get by. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. See, life's like a beach if you find the sand. And right now, I'm feeling like $100,000.
You are listening to Inspired Insider with your host, Dr. Jeremy Weisz.
Dr. Jeremy Weisz here. I'm here with Rick Cesari. We are live from the Prosper Show. And Rick is the marketing mind behind Juice Man Juicer, George Foreman Grill, OxyClean, and what was the other one, Rick?
GoPro Camera.
GoPro Camera. I mean, the list goes on and on. But we have Rick here, so I wanted to have him talk about the must-have components of an infomercial, because these same components can be translated into webinar or other forms of media, and he is the expert. So some of the must-haves of components of an infomercial.
Great. Well, first of all, Jeremy, it's great to see you.
Great to see you.
Yeah. So must-have components of an infomercial, the most important thing, several real important things. One, start with a great product, something that people need. You know, it's really hard to market a product to an audience that doesn't, respond to that. And that seems like very simple common sense, but a lot of people don't do their due diligence or research. So find out that a market and a product that people want to buy or they need. Second thing, I always start every project I work on with testimonials. And testimonials are a great built-in focus group. You talk to people that have purchased the product. They tell you what they like, what they don't like. Then you use that footage that you get, are the statements that you get from the testimonials as proof that that other people are buying the product, that they like the product, and people don't like to be the first one in line. And so if they know other people are buying your product and like it and have had success, it breaks down barriers and makes it easier to sell.
So talk about that. What are the best ways to gather testimonials, especially if no one's used the product before?
So I'm gonna answer that question in two parts. First of all, the easiest projects for us to always work on are companies that have some minimal amount of sales. So there's people using their product. And again, I'll go back, the first thing we do, go talk to those people. They'll tell you everything you need to know about what you need to do to successfully sell the product. But if you don't have, people aren't using your product, you have to get some type of prototypes or samples of the product, distribute it to 15 to 20 people, depending on the type of product it is. If they get results quickly, you can go back and talk to them. Sometimes people have to use it for 2 weeks or 4 weeks, but create your own testimonials by letting them use the product and then go back and talk to the people and go through the same thing I mentioned before.
So you have many years experience in infomercials. What's something that has surprised you of what's happened? I know you have several examples from the George Foreman Grill days, but something that happened in the infomercial that actually increased sales that you would have never expected, but you've tested so many things before.
Yeah, you mentioned the George Foreman one, and that's a good example, because we thought when we were making the original George Foreman infomercial that if we put footage in of George knocking out Michael Moore, because he was the oldest guy ever to win the heavyweight championship, and I was a guy, I liked boxing, I thought that would be a really great story. So we paid $15,000 to HBO to buy 8 seconds worth of footage, put it in a commercial, and nobody bought anything. And that goes back to knowing your target customer. And in this case, the target customer was mostly women. Most women don't like boxing. When the commercial started with boxing footage, nobody bought the grill. As soon as we took the footage out, the commercial started working great, and the rest is history.
And another thing about the infomercials are the call to action. Can you talk about some of maybe best practices when introducing a call to action in whether it's an infomercial or a webinar?
So I'm a big believer in infomercials, webinars, of always educating the consumer. And you do that through the process of the commercial that they're watching or the webinar that you're doing. And the more that you can educate the consumer, when it comes time for them for you to ask for the order in the CTA or to call to action, your job is very easy, because instead of trying to do a hard sell, you've really laid out a reasonable path for the people to buy your product. And then when it comes time, you're really just asking for the order and giving people an opportunity to order. And one of the biggest mistakes I see a lot of people make, a lot of advertising agencies, people marketing products, is they don't make it really clear when asking for the order. You have to, you know, once you create awareness, you educate people, they're sold on your product, make it easy for them to order.
You know, another thing I was thinking, Rick, you produced one of the first OxiClean commercials with Billy Mays.
Right.
So talk about just working with Billy Mays and producing those infomercials.
And it wasn't one of the first. It was the very first OxiClean infomercial and the very first one Billy Mays ever did. And Billy was an old school pitch man. He learned the craft selling direct to consumer on the Atlantic City boardwalk and at state fairs all over the country. And the one thing, neat thing about doing that was that Billy asked that we take a camera and keep it about 4 feet in front of him so that he could talk right into the camera lens, just like there was he was speaking to a crowd of people or a group of people, and he really was able to turn on, I guess, an extra gear. And all the really good, even performers do this, where they might be quiet. George Foreman was the same way. He was a real quiet man. But the minute you got him in front of the camera, got him on stage, he'd go into high gear, and Billy was the same way.
I see that in you too, actually. big mistakes people make. Because you probably see infomercials and webinars. What are some big mistakes people are making in webinars right now?
Big mistakes.
Like maybe they're not including certain components or emphasizing certain things. Anything you are seeing? Or maybe a big mistake you made that you had to correct for. In an infomercial. No worries. Juice Man Juicer. No, we don't edit anything. Juice Man Juicer. Some lessons from Jay.
Yeah, so the Juice Man was really interesting, and I'll talk a little bit about this in my talk tomorrow. But at the time, the two most popular juicers on the market were two firms from Germany, Braun's and Krupp's, and they were really proud of their German engineering. And they were selling the juicer as an appliance, and they were focusing on the features of the appliance, a half horsepower motor, stainless steel cutting blade, dishwasher safe plastic, and they were selling it like an appliance. And when we came in and started selling the juicer, we focused on the benefits of the juice. We never even talked about the juicer. We talked about how drinking fresh juice could help you live longer, give you more energy, lower cholesterol, all the benefits that people would love to get, and the business really took off.
I could literally talk to you for hours, but I know you got to prepare for your keynote. So live from the Prosper, thank you, Rick. And people should check out also Cesari Direct.
It's actually CesariMedia now. We rebranded.
Okay. CesariMedia.com. CesariMedia.com. Thank you.
What I got, you can't buy. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. See, nice like a peaches.